The home that we inspected today was a home that had a vented crawl space. Here you can see the screen that's very low to the ground, and if any water overflows with the gutter or you have poor drainage where the two fingers are pointing, water will go into this crawl space and then kind of just sit down into the crawl space and evaporate into the crawl space. The crawl space also was very small, and we had to incorporate the use of a remote control car. The crawl space depth probably was areas 8 inches up to an average of 14 inches and some 15 or 16. And a lot of plumbing, which would include domestic and sanitary, and then also mechanical devices and mechanical HVAC ductwork was in the way. And so actually climbing around in this crawl space was very difficult. Not only that, would be very dangerous because the crawl space did have debris scattered throughout, which would include glass or light bulbs or metal, tin, and etc. And it would be very difficult to maneuver in this confined space, and if you were to get cut or hurt, it would be a very a big issue because you wouldn't be able to get out. In the 40s, 50s, 60s, 70s, they did install a lot of vented crawl spaces. The only problem with vented crawl spaces is that the vents would also allow cold air to go in during the winter, and the floors would be cold. And in the summertime, with the air conditioners on, warm air would go in that's moist and cause condensation and possibly permit mold, mildew, and that was a problem causing odors in homes. Additionally, these vented crawl spaces would have insulation on the ceilings, which probably is not optimal. As you can see in this video, that's how these were done. Also, if you notice this video, the vapor barrier, which is that metal foil, is also installed on the cold part. And generally, you want that on the heated part. But that doesn't really make a difference because we're going to talk about changing this whole design. Today, in cold weather climate zones such as Ohio, you want a conditioned crawl space. And conditioned crawl space would include a vapor barrier on the floor, 100% sealed, as you can see here. The stone is, you don't have that here. And then also, you don't want insulation above, and you can see that you do have insulation above in this vented crawl space. You want perimeter insulation, you want proper water management, you want heating, cooling, and dehumidification. You basically want to treat your crawl space like a living room. And that is the only way to ensure to have proper building science and proper conditions in the upper home. So what we'll do now is we'll kind of just look at what we're seeing in this crawl space, and we'll kind of talk about some of the things. Here you can see where the insulation is falling down, and the reason the insulation is falling down is because it's old, it gets heavy, the fasteners and staples get rusted, and of course moisture builds up into it and it falls. So you've got hot and cold spots in the floor. Here you could actually see in another location where there is a access panel that somebody had added to this crawl space. I believe that in the past people had to add access spaces or access openings just to get down in there, and what they did is cut the floor open and add an access, perform their work, close up the floor. In the process here, you could actually see where they cut the joist, and so you've got a free joist just floating and it's not even boxed in. These conditions, cutting joists under crawl spaces will cause some deflection, and so you need to go through this crawl space, remove all the insulation, and then look at all the joists, and any joist that is cut, split, will require sistering and stiffening. At this location also, you'll see what appears to be a sub pump without a cover, and the sub pump generally has water in it, and it'll evaporate and cause a continuous high humidity and possible dew point condensation. Sub pumps probably should have 100% sealed lids on them. Additionally, sub pumps should be inspected, tested, and you should consider having a battery backup on the sub pump. This sub pump has holes in it to let water drain in, but it's dry today, but you can see how the walls are moist and it is an active sub pump. Additionally, you'll see that there's some sloppy wiring, and I don't know if that's an extension cord or it's a heating cord or what, but really you shouldn't have extension cord or zip cords used anywhere in homes, especially in crawl spaces. Here you see the ductwork's being supported by wood timbers, and the wood timbers are on the ground that gets wet. And you know, that's not a good way of supporting ductwork or plumbing. There's a column support right here, or jack, that does not appear to be doing anything, and maybe this was intended to help lift the floor, or maybe they used it when they cut that particular joist member, as you can see. The crawl space had some footers that the walls and piers are resting on, and when the ground gets wet, you can get some settlement. So you don't want to have any moisture getting in the crawl spaces, either, you know, from vents from the exterior or from hydrostatic pressure from below or from leakage. What you're looking at here is ductwork and plumbing that is in the unconditioned space. In other words, it's in the cold space. So now it's going to take a lot longer to get hot water in your pipes. Your ductwork will be also cold in the winter, hot possibly in the summer, and energy efficiency is very poor. So we also recommend insulating all cold water pipes, domestic pipes, and all ductwork. And additionally, the ductwork should be inspected, and all ductwork should be sealed to not permit any duct leakage. You do not want to leak any air, and if there's cold air returns in a crawl space, you definitely don't want them sucking air out of a crawl space. So you want to seal all the ductwork. In this area also, you'll see what appears to be some type of damper, electronic damper, possibly to help or enhance air flows. So the home may also have uneven heating. And if you don't have cold air returns in all the bedrooms and all rooms, then sometimes you have pressurized rooms and depressurized rooms. And we did see that. Here you'll see the insulation does have stains, and some of the timbers and insulation has mold and mildew. So when you rip out all this insulation, when you clean this, you'll also have to treat and sanitize all the timbers and remove any mold or mildew. And generally this is just surface mold and mildew and can be easily removed as long as you have access under. Some of the sanitary pipes that were sloppy, and you know, you have to think about this. Men would have to get in the small crawl space. They don't have all day. They're going to do the repair as quick as they possibly can, and so it's going to be pretty sloppy. Probably acceptable, but some areas did have sloppy welded joints and sloppy glue joints, and even some drainage wasn't proper, and you know, you might get restrictions and you might have to snake lines. You can also see that there was a poor attempt of a vapor barrier installation. The vapor barrier is wrinkled, damaged, stained. It looks like it floods periodically. There's mud on it, and it'll all have to be taken out along with all the insulation. A lot of the pipes had sloppy hangers that will need to be properly hung. And you also see the vents here where air comes into the vents. These are the exterior vents. You'll probably have to seal those and waterproof those when you convert this to a crawl space. There is another sub pump pit or possible pit for some type of plumbing. A lot of the plumbing discharge pipes are sloppy. Some are poorly sloped, and the locations where they're poorly sloped, they can clog. And you can see right above his head where the pipe is poorly sloped, and this could plug up. So it appears that you're going to have to completely change this crawl space, remove all the insulation, remove all the plastic. You're going to have to scrape it, clean it, make it accessible. Then you're going to have to install a 100% sealed vapor barrier. You're going to have to install perimeter insulation. You're going to have to heat it, cool it, condition it, seal the exterior vents, and seal those and waterproof those so water's not get in. And most importantly, you'll have to dehumidify. Some of the piping will have to be refastened, and a lot of the joists will need to be looked at, cleaned, freed of any mold and mildew. You're going to have to install joist hangers at numerous locations. Several joists will need to be stiffened, sistered, and repaired, and several columns will need to be adjusted or made more stable. So you can do this a lot of different ways. Radon blankets are the best. This is a radon blanket that radon companies use. It's white and black on the other side, and you want to put this down 100% sealed up on the side walls. You want to make sure all the debris and sharp items are also removed from the floor before you do this and install it so it doesn't puncture it. The perimeter walls will need to be insulated, and you could use foam like in this photo here, or you can use fiberglass, whatever, and you can also insulate the band joist. You don't want the ceiling insulated. You want that to be heated, cooled. You want to run a supply duct in there, and you do not want to have any differential pressures, especially negative pressure. So all duct work should be clean, should be sealed, and HVAC should be balanced. Now you'll remove the moisture source and you'll have a more comfortable home. You won't have odors in a home. A lot of times high moisture causes mold in attics, on sheeting, and closets, and it'll just be a better home. So we recommend changing this crawl space to a conditioned crawl space. Finally, you're going to have to take care of all exterior water sources. You want water to go away from the home. You don't want water ponding at the foundation. You want proper grading. You want to minimize ice dams, which generally are caused by heat loss in the unconditioned attic space. You want to possibly even waterproof, if you need to, the interior or exterior, and you may even have to install a proper sub-pump discharge system in the crawl space. So water management is a key item to minimize any moisture that will get into a crawl space or under a crawl space through headers. For more information, go to www.houseinvestigations.com.